Mr. Excel Podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Check out the Mr. Excel Podcast live when I do Power Excel in Tampa, Florida on Friday, May 9th, 2014. Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 1880, extract suffix to new column. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Today's question sent in by Michael. He has a column of values and he needs to get the suffix, everything after the dash, over to a new column. And the tricky part is the amount of characters before the dash and after the dash might be different in every case. So I need to use the mid function. We're going to ask for the mid of that text there. But where do I want to start? Oh, that's the really hard part. I'm going to use the find in quotes, look for a dash within that text over there in A2 and add one. So that'll locate where the dash is and then start one more than that. And at this point, I really have a couple of choices. I could ask for the length of A2 minus the find plus one, or we could just ask for some insanely large number like 10 and know that that will get all of the characters. The big question is, if we ask for more characters than what are there, what are they going to do? Are they going to pad it with spaces, or are they going to just give us the characters that are there? Great news, they just give us the characters that are there. So that's one way to go. The beautiful thing here is if we discover that there's an error and we correct it, it will get corrected in the formula. If you know that this data is not going to change at all, then a much faster way to go is with data text to column, so Alt-D-E. I'm going to say the data is delimited. In step two, I'm going to say it's delimited by the dash. And very carefully in step three, I'm going to say, hey, we do not want to import the first column. We only want to import the second column. And the destination is not going to be column A, it's going to be column B. Click finish, and we get just the suffix. Now, if something changes here, it won't change there. Same thing with this one. This is an Excel 2013 trick using flash fill. It creates a, see, they could see the flash fill was there, but then they decided against it. So we're going to come back here to data and flash fill. Also, make sure that they got the B19 correct. It's strange that they could sense there was an answer there, but then they must not have been sure enough, so they backed out. Again, this is only in Excel 2013. And in the example that Michael sent, his values before the dash were always exactly the same. If that happens to be the case, I wasn't sure from Michael's data if I was just seeing a small portion of it or not. We can actually just count here that we want to start in 8 for a length of 10, and that will reliably work if you know the values before the dash are always the same. Well, hey, I want to thank Michael for sending that question in. I actually met Michael at one of my live Power Excel seminars, so check out the one in Tampa. I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel. Tips and tricks, get your spreadsheet fixed at MrExcel.com.